Good morning. Well, the young folks who just stood before us, let's just stop and think for a moment what we just experienced. Young people that are engaged and involved, that have brought before us today their ideas, their challenges, and the direction we can go. That is so encouraging to me to see this happening right here in our city of Jacksonville. So can you please give them another big round of applause? We are all in this together. Please stand up. Thank you. So just to recap what we just heard, Maisha reminded us that we all, each and every one of us, matter. Patrick advised us that we are often our own worst enemy. And Taylor encouraged us that it is in fact, a wonderful world. Ironically, the same year that A Wonderful World was recorded, the song that Taylor referenced, is the same year that Dr. King delivered a speech to the Southern Christian Leadership Conference 10th Anniversary Convention. It was entitled, "Where Do We Go From Here?" Dr. King gave a riveting account of the conditions of that period: high rates of unemployment, climbing infant mortality rates and health disparities, poor education outcomes, and widespread violence and rioting. The issues that Dr. King identified in 1967, if we're being truthful with ourselves, sound painfully similar to many of the issues that we face today, not only as a country, but as a city. We have to be honest with ourselves if we're going to make progress. So Jacksonville, I will ask you today, and not nearly as eloquently, but the question is really, where do we, as a city, go from here? The journey that I come in leads us to a one city, one Jacksonville. And in that goal, there will be cynics along the way, and we're going to have to move beyond the cynics. There will be critics along the way, and I've said before, and I'll say it again, I welcome the critics to one city, one Jacksonville, because that will push us, and that will push me to our better and our higher selves. So we're going to set the goal here, and it is going to be an ever-striving moment towards one city, one Jacksonville. The journey that I commit to leading brings us closer to that place. There's been an incredible foundation laid in our city by civil rights leaders who walked alongside Dr. King, such as the late Dr. Margaret Haley, who was deemed the father of St. Augustine's civil rights movement. When I took the oath last summer and I stood on the stage with my wife Molly and my three kids, Boyd, Brooke, and Bridget, with me, I pledged to support resources and everything that I have within my authority to bring the same educational opportunities, neighborhood conditions, and community safety offerings that my family has come to expect in the city of Jacksonville. While we certainly have a staggering pension debt, which you may have read about and seen on television in recent years, particularly the whirlwind trips that myself and the efforts the council and I have been making in recent weeks, while we have this staggering pension debt that cripples us, I have made it incredibly clear that my budget and my efforts will include public safety as the highest priority. Simply put, communities thrive when communities are safe. Over the past 6 months, I've worked very closely with someone who's become a friend and a partner, and that is Sheriff Mike Williams. Mike, if you would please stand up. I am so proud to tell you that you have, with the two of us, partners in this. Servant leaders that want to do the right thing by this community and make sure that we have all the opportunities before us. We are working with key initiatives to reduce violent crime through our city, and I'm proud to say in my first budget, I added 40 additional police officers and 40 community service officers. And while adding officers to the streets is helpful, and we will continue in the years ahead, it is by no means complete. The sheriff and I agree that we cannot police our way out of violence. Dr. King did not call for a greater number of police officers. He called for greater communities. And we build stronger communities by building stronger relationships between citizens, government, and law enforcement. That is to say that we are in this together. That is to say that we are brothers and sisters, and that through all of this, we must remember that we must and should love one another. To truly solve crime, we must also focus on the causes of crime, not only with robust intervention programs, which we have, but with significant investments in prevention efforts. There is tremendous evidence in national research that speaks to the power of prevention, and we don't have to look very far. In 2011, Jacksonville's murder and violent crime rates were at 40-year lows, and they were a direct result of a program that former Mayor John Payton launched with community leaders, many of you in this room, the Jacksonville Journey. I am delighted to say that the journey continues, and my administration and I are relaunching it with a 100% increase in funding. A start with a $5 million investment in programs and offerings that create more promising futures for tomorrow's leaders. One of the most successful programs within Jack's Journey is led by the Duval County Public Schools that has dramatically improved out-of-school suspension and achievement. It is the ATOS program, the Alternative to Out-of-School Suspension. I spent an afternoon there, a couple of hours there one day. And when you get in there and you see what the hard work of the people that care about these young folks are doing, and you see when you put these young people in an environment where they know we care about them, it makes a difference. The data is very clear. A few short weeks ago, I was blessed with the opportunity to tour the jail, second chance champion of our time. You all know him. In fact, a person who actually attended Morehouse College with Dr. King, Richard McKissick. Richard co-founded and directed a city program called Dawn that helped persons impacted by incarceration, unemployment, and substance abuse develop the skills, training, and education to improve their lives. I can tell you that that tour was one of the most moving experiences that I've had either during the campaign or since I've been in office. Richard led me into a place with men that want to know that they have a second chance, that want to know that we care about them, and I'll tell you it's powerful when you look someone in the eye that wants to life and tell them I believe in you, and when you have someone like Richard who led that cause. Bishop, thank you for sharing your brother with this city for so many years. If I could listen to a conversation being held in heaven now between Richard McKissick and Dr. King, I'm sure Richard would tell him about the Dawn program and how much progress our community has made. However, he'd also be forced to tell him about the tremendous work that lies ahead. Health disparities continue to plague this community. The infant mortality rates in sectors of our community are comparable to third world countries. That is unacceptable, ladies and gentlemen. It is these rates which define the health and well-being of a community. Jacksonville is currently ranked 43rd out of 67 counties throughout the state for quality health outcomes. I don't want those results for our community, and that's why in the weeks ahead, I will be launching our citywide wellness campaign. We will introduce programs, opportunities, and partners to share my vision for equipping and supporting every citizen, and every zip code with resources to live well in Jacksonville, Florida. I am incredibly excited to have Dr. Samson Davis and a recognized emergency physician here with us today as our keynote speaker. We had a little opportunity to talk about social media and Twitter. So check us out on Twitter when you leave today. Doctor, when you return to our city, I hope that you'll see that our outcome has improved when you come back and give us our next checkup. I'm convinced that we have made great progress toward a greater community, a wonderful world, as Taylor calls it. So what will that look like? Today I have my Youth Leadership Advisory Council here with me today, a great group of young people. If you'll just stand up for a moment, please. Young people, right there in the back, give them a round of applause. Another small glimpse into what this might look like. Joining us this morning is my special guest are the Forest View Steelers football team, whose home field is Yancey Park, located in District 10, led by Councilwoman Katrina Brown. Will you all please stand, 10 and 11-year-old champions. They are champions. This past season, the Steelers had an undefeated regular season in which they held all of their opponents scoreless. They were crowned city champions of the South Region and state champions, leading them to the coveted opportunity to play in the Pop Warner Super Bowl. They represented our city. Give them a round of applause. Our community and our entire Southeast region, and more importantly, our future in the national championship game they recently played in Orlando. Their coach, JSO Corrections Officer Eric Wesley, has been coaching the Steelers for 20 years. He's here with the team today. Please stand up. Eric and I were talking a few minutes ago. I coach my son's youth football team, and based on this record, the defensive effort, I'm going to be looking for some pointers and tips. We don't play each other, so I hope you'll share the secrets. When the Steelers begin next season, Coach Wesley will probably ask them, where can we go from here? That's tough when you achieve that level of success, Coach. As a youth football coach, I know the hope, optimism, and excitement that come with the beginning of each new season. And I know the discipline, determination, and passion that is required for success. It is with that same enthusiasm, passion, and discipline I serve as your mayor. In closing, I challenge each of you to join me in demonstrating acts and opportunities that will influence and inspire the journey for ourselves, our communities, and more importantly, our leaders for tomorrow. With that, we are one city, always striving to be one city, one Jacksonville. And please leave here today and remember to let's love one another. Thank you.